Thank you everyone for joining us for our teaching resource webinar. I'm sure that you're all deep into your planning for the fall semester and being asked to make many adaptations to your regular teaching. As a reminder, we are the Ontario Agricultural College Liaison Program. I'm Carly, the OAC Liaison Manager.
And I'm Christine, the OAC Liaison Officer.
And what we do is we build awareness of the academic career pathways in agriculture, environment, communities, and provide event and resources for high school teachers and students. The OAC Liaison Program is also temporarily pivoted to online and virtual events and resources until further notice. So this means that our regular face-to-face offerings like the in-class visits and on-campus experiences are currently unavailable. But the good news is that we have lots of other options to share with you today.
We also understand each school board may be taking a different approach, so we are also hoping to gain some insight on how to best accommodate different teaching schedules and preferred online platforms. As you know, this is a three-part series. This first segment, we will briefly touch on all of our events and resources. In the second segment, we'll take a closer look at our events. And then our final segment is a deeper dive into our resources. So let's get started.
So the first opportunity that we want to share with you is our virtual facility tours. So each one of these events is a unique opportunity to attend a behind-the-scenes look at some of our research facilities. Each event will include a pre-event activity that will connect to the content. So this can be facilitated in class or at home. So an example of one of these activities is the Arboretum activity may ask students to survey the biodiversity around their home or school and then do some species identification. So additionally, every student will also receive an academic program material package that will include a University of Guelph view book, as well as program brochures that are related to the facility. So again, as the example with the Arboretum, we would include an environment program brochure. We'll also include any activity materials that students might need to do their pre-event activity. So again, the example of the Arboretum, we have biodiversity sheets that we would also include in that package. It is important to note that there is a deadline for each facility tour that you must register before if you'd like your materials before the live event. Otherwise, they may arrive after. So on the live event, we'll have video footage of the facility, as well as a live Q&A with the researchers from the respective facility on that event date. We'll also be providing some post-event discussion questions that you can facilitate after the event with your students. The dates for the facilities that we'll be covering in the fall include the Honeybee Research Center, the Arboretum, the Ontario Dairy Research Center, the Ontario Beef Research Center, and the Soil Health Interpretive Center. So we will be scheduling other facilities for the winter semester. Our newsletter will be where we'll release those dates and details first, so make sure that you register if you haven't already.
The next opportunity I'll talk about is virtual guest speakers. This kind of takes place of those on-campus and in-class experiences we would typically do. The specialists in a variety of different fields have offered their expertise to speak to your class about over 15 different topics. To book a speaker, you can review the available topics and complete a request form on our website. On the form, you'll indicate a few options for dates and times, and we'll coordinate with the speakers to confirm. Prior to the speaker visit, you will be provided with a pre-event activity instruction that your students can complete on their own. Topics of these include animal housing and welfare, the buzz on bees, soil and essential resource, insect inspectors, all about trees, exploring food chemistry, the gluten project, ending global hunger, economics as an environmental science, economic impacts of COVID-19 on the agri-food sector, what's on your plate, landscape architecture, food insecurity, labor and technology, food waste, and the future of agriculture, Ag 4.0. And there are more in development, which is super exciting. So when you complete the request form, you are completing it for one class and one topic only. If you would like another topic or an additional class, please complete another request form, as this helps us to stay organized. Another great opportunity we have are our online lesson plans, which are downloadable PDFs. Each lesson plan has been aligned with Ontario High School curricula, and experts on our campus, including faculty, students, and staff, have developed each plan with activities and thought-provoking discussions. Also included are cross-curricular links, assessment strategies, learning objectives, and materials. New this year are lesson plans around climate change, soil, food security, economics and agricultural business, landscape architecture, and plans that utilize episodes from the Why and How podcast. The Why and How podcast looks to answer big questions in agriculture, food, and the environment through casual conversations rooted in research. Each episode is an interview with a researcher from the Ontario Agricultural College. Topics of these include bees, climate change, urban heat, nutraceuticals, plant-based meat, and dairy cow genetics, just to name a few.
So the next events that I want to talk about are program information nights. So these opportunities are specifically designed for grade 11 and 12 students. We do understand how stressful it is for students that are making post-secondary choices that don't have the same opportunities as usual to attend events on university campuses or interact with university representatives to ask their questions. So we've designed program information nights as a chance to learn about our academic programs, and they'll have a chance to engage with current students in programs, recent alumni, and faculty. These will start with a program presentation, and then it'll be followed by a panel of the students, grads, and faculty. We've scheduled them all so that they are before the date when the OUAC 2021 applications will open. And they're planned by theme with programs that are similar. So those dates are as follows. Plants on September 23rd, agriculture and food, business and economics on September 30th, food on October 7th, environment on October 14th, and animals on October 21st. If you want more information about which programs will be covered, all of the upcoming events are listed on our upcoming events page, where they'll be listed with more details about each one of those dates. As supporters and influencers, we really do hope that you pass on this opportunity to your grade 11 and 12 students. This event also welcomes parents, teachers, and guidance counselors who are interested in learning more about our academic programs.
If you or your students are interested in receiving academic program information, we will send it to you. Each package will include a University of Guelph viewbook and OAC program brochures of your choice. Brochures include agriculture, landscape architecture, food science and business, environment, and animals. You can get a full class set or individual set. This can be sent to a personal address or a school. These are free resources and can be requested on our website.
So the next event that I want to talk about is really just to save the date and to keep your eyes open for future details. So the Royal Agricultural Winter Fair is going virtual this year. Each year we host a education symposium, and this year the title is Your Pathway to a Future in Food. So this is scheduled for November 12th. The main programming will likely take place in the morning, but there are still some details being confirmed. This is aimed at high school students, and it's a career-focused event. This will include a keynote speaker, a diverse range of panelists of recent graduates that are working in their field that include food production, policy, business, and plants. So there are more details to come. Keep that eye out on our upcoming events page for more details. You can also follow us on Twitter, where we'll be sharing updates.
And just as a reminder, the upcoming webinar dates, when you did sign up for this first one, you would get automatic registration for the other two as well. So on September 15th, we'll be having a closer look at our events throughout the semester. And then on September 29th, we'll be taking a deeper dive into our different resources.
And we also want to emphasize those other opportunities for your students, especially when it comes to the senior students, as I said, that are trying to make their post-secondary choices during this really strange time. So we do invite them to visit U of G virtually at admission.uofguelph.ca/visit-u-g-virtually. There's some virtual tour options, links to additional information. Another great recommendation is to ask them to follow at U of G admission. So there will be updates on important information and deadlines, as well as some Q&A sessions that take place on that account. You're also welcome to pass on our contact information to your students to reach out to us directly. If we cannot answer their question, we will make sure that we connect them with a person who can. Thank you so much for joining us. We do hope to engage with you through one of our opportunities this semester. Please feel free to forward any of your questions to us. And again, to pass on our contact information to students that might want to talk further about academic programs.